So my Premiere Pro community and video editor friends out there, how often have we done this where we've spent the time making a beautiful edit and we've done all of our work color grading and effects and sequencing and we are ready to export, and after waiting probably a good long time for it to finish, we get a result that looks like this. So why does this happen? Well, I don't really know, but I know a way to fix it. And today I'm going to talk to you about how you can utilize a simple single step to ensure the color quality of your video matches what you spent all that precious time on. So let's roll. So welcome back, everybody. My name's Steven, and this is a quick one on video editing, but it's an important one, especially if you use Premiere Pro for your editing flow, as well as coloring workflow, which I know I should be using DaVinci, but I probably should be using DaVinci for everything nowadays, but I still use Premiere. So how do you make this program work properly when it comes to color grading and exporting your video? But there is a trick that you can use to ensure that your colors look like what you're editing and not something that looks like a magazine that was left out in the rain. So let's hop into Premiere Pro and I'll show you the trick and how to make sure you ensure, let's just say, your color and correct color for your grade export. So my friends, welcome to Premiere Pro CC. We've spent days, we've spent weeks and sleepless nights to create this beautiful 3.21 second video of me pointing at you. Now this is a work of cinematic achievement and we've spent time with the sequence, with sound editing, we've done color grading, we've done effects and after effects because after all, that's what we've done here. And we've made a piece of cinematic achievement if I haven't said that before. So now we're gonna render this out and share it with the world. So we go over here to File and we go down to Export and we go over to Media and we take a look at all the settings here. We're gonna take a look that it all looks good. We're gonna render that maximum depth. We're gonna pass that because that's not important. We're gonna pass that maximum render quality because that's not important too. And we're gonna go down past the VBR settings and we're not even gonna use that. We're gonna use one pass because that ensures the highest quality. And we're gonna title this video as the best video ever. And because it really is, it is the best video ever. And we're gonna go down here and we're gonna pass all the audio and the captions and the effects. We're not gonna do any of that. We're gonna basically render this video out to share it with the world. So here we go, we're rendering. And mind you, this is also a MacBook Pro 16-inch, I believe, with an M1 Pro chip. So yeah, lightning fast. We're at 21 seconds now at 31%. Haha, success. We are at 100% and our video has exported successfully. That little blue box of happiness makes us as editors feel relieved and achieved that we've made this new piece of work. So let's go take a look at this new piece of work as we prepare to put it on Vimeo or Facebook or LinkedIn or Twitter or Instagram or TikTok or whatever platform you want to use. Let's take a look. What? Where's all the color? Why is it blown out? Why is it not anything that I've spent my time on? Where's the contrast and the saturation and the shadows and the highlights and the effects and the LUTs that I put on this to make this video look good? Well, my friends, this is where this video comes into play because as you can see, this is what we created. And this is what we got. So how do we correct this and make sure this never happens? So in order to do that, there's a simple, very easy step that you can do. And that is called a QT gamma compensation LUT. What this Q file does is it corrects all the horrible things that Premiere Pro does to us as editors. And it ensures that the video quality and the saturation and the coloring and all the styling we've done is maintained on export. So how do you do this? Well, it's quite simple. Go over here and go back to those export settings in media. And we're gonna take a look at what we have here. So under video, we're gonna go down to, of course, selecting render at maximum depth and use maximum render quality. We're gonna scroll down even further and we're gonna take a look at our bitrate settings. And I always recommend going with a two pass if you're working with MP4 files. If you're working with ProRes files, it's a completely different ballgame, but since it's H.264, we're gonna make this super quick and super efficient. However, super high quality. So once we have those two things selected, we're gonna go over here now, we're gonna call this the best video ever part two. So as you can tell, if I turn on this effect and turn it off again, there is something happening in Premiere Pro. What it is, nobody knows. But when I go over here and I apply this area of select and I look up gamma compensation cube, which I've already downloaded, I'm gonna apply this. And when I make sure that my settings are correct and I've all, you know, made sure it's at maximum render depth and also render quality, and that my bitrate settings are correct, and that we have this Lumetri look area here going, and also the application that's correctly selected, even though it says none. Why it says none, no one knows. But why this is selected, now we can actually export this video. And as we export it, for whatever reason, it no longer takes more than a minute to export a 3-second video. Why? These are mysteries that you and I will never solve. Ooh, getting lots of emails right now. Anyways, we now have this blue box of success, and let's take a look at our final video. We have here a properly rendered out video that has the coloring that we've spent all those hard days and nights making sure that we have the highest quality results. Always use the gamma compensation cube, but you may ask, friends, where do you find this gamma compensation cube? And I can tell you, there's a very simple place to find it. So here comes the shameless plug part of the video, because now we can take a look at my website. So www.stephenbell.ca is my personal CV portfolio site that I've done through Squarespace. Now, Squarespace is not promoting this video, so that's not the purpose of this. But why I bring it up is that I have given you the ability of downloading this LUT for free with no sign up, no purchasing, no nothing. It's just there for you to use. Go over to my work area, go to LUTs and downloads, just scroll down to the bottom of that area and you will find an area that has a link for the Gamma QT Gamma Compensation LUT. You're gonna select that and it's gonna download that LUT for you right to your computer. There's nothing more frustrating than spending time in Premiere Pro, which is already a frustrating software in itself, to not get the end result that you spent so much time on. There's too many quirks in that software, and if you're utilizing the Mac M1 technology environment, you're gonna run into more issues. So if you can outwit and outsmart Premiere Pro, just do it. You can find the LUT on my website, www.stephenbell.ca. It's free, no sign up, no nothing, just download it and use it. Or just use DaVinci, and then none of these problems will exist anyways. Until next time, I will talk to you later about more ideas on editing and reviews and gear and all kinds of suggestions on how you can make your videos the best that they can be. Peace.